Without a plan, revision can be stressful and lead to poor exam results. In this podcast, I guide students through one part of such a plan, study resources. First, we cover the theory for each topic, and then I suggest questions to practice acquired skills. Join me in making your exam experience a success story. So let's learn more about unit circle. The unit circle is a circle centered at the origin with a radius of 1. Since it has a radius of 1, it can be used to directly find sine and cosine values, depending on the x and y coordinates of a point. If theta is the angle that the vector to the point makes with the x-axis, then the x-coordinate is given by cosine theta, and the y-coordinate is given by sine theta. The question that relates to this theory is, find the coordinates of the point marked on the given diagram. There is a link in the show notes of this episode in case you want to double-check the answer for this question. Do you know anyone who could benefit from listening to this episode? Share it with them. That's how we can support more students in preparing for their exams. Also, if you like listening to this podcast, it would be awesome if you left a 5-star rating or a review. Okay, so let's have a look at graphs of trigonometric functions. The graphs for sine and cosine are almost identical, with the only difference being that the cosine graph is the sine graph shifted by 90 degrees to the right. The graphs for sine and cosine both have an amplitude of 1, meaning that the maximum value that the two trigonometric functions can take is 1. They are both 360 degrees periodic, meaning that the graph will be repeated after every 360 degrees. The cosine graph is symmetric over the y-axis, since when it is flipped across it, the two halves of the graph match up. On the other hand, the graph of sine is symmetric about the origin, since the graph is flipped over both the x-axis and the y-axis. This means that for every x value with a corresponding value of y, minus x matches to minus y. Tangent graph is significantly different to both sine and cosine graphs. The graph of tangent is 180 degrees periodic. The graph passes through the origin and tends to infinity in the positive direction and negative infinity in the negative direction, and thus its amplitude is undefined. Since tangent is undefined for odd multiples of 90 degrees, at these values of x, the graph of tangent has asymptotes. Now let's mention a question that could be asked in this topic. Explain why the graph of tangent has asymptotes. There's a link in the show notes of this episode in case you want to double-check the answer for this question. Many students revise for exams without a plan. This can result in sporadic learning, poor exam results, and worse career opportunities. However, you can avoid that. Generate your personal exam revision plan on studiesquare.co.uk/plan. Okay, so let's have a look at transformations of trigonometric graphs. If y equals f of x is a trigonometric function, then y equals f of, in the brackets, ax, is a horizontal stretch of scale factor 1 over a, whereas y equals a, f of x, is a vertical stretch with a scale factor a. Y equals f brackets minus x close brackets is a reflection in the y-axis, whereas y equals minus f of x is a reflection in the x-axis. Y equals f of x plus c outside of the brackets is a translation of c units up, whereas y equals f brackets x plus c close brackets is a translation of c units to the left. Now let's mention a question that could be asked in this topic. State the maximum amplitude reached by the graph of y equals 7 sine x plus 2. There is a link in the show notes of this episode in case you want to double check the answer for this question. Did you know that we have other podcasts for math and science? If you are interested to learn more, search for Revision with Jonas on Apple Podcasts or Spotify. Okay, so let's have a look at graphs of inverse trigonometric functions. Both arcsine and arccos have a domain between minus 1 and 1 inclusive, whereas arctan has an infinite domain. The ranges of arcsine, arccos, and arctan are between minus pi over 2 and pi over 2 inclusive, between 0 and pi inclusive, and minus pi over 2 and pi over 2 respectively. The domains and ranges of arccsine and arccos come from the range and domain of sine and cosine respectively. Since tangent has an infinite range, arctan has an infinite domain. So let's see an example of a problem for this theory. Provide the domain of the arctan graph. If you want to see the answer and the solution for this question, use the link in the show notes of this episode. So let's learn more about graphs of reciprocal trigonometric functions. The graphs for the reciprocal trigonometric functions have asymptotes where the standard trigonometric functions have roots. This is because taking the reciprocal of zero is undefined. The question that relates to this theory is, explain the magnitude of the minimum value that second can take. There is a link in the show notes of this episode in case you want to double check the answer for this question. Now that we have covered the theory, it is time to practice solving related problems. So head to studiesquare.co.uk/resources and try answering questions on this topic. I hope you have a great week ahead, and until next time.